Hello friends, welcome to our channel and to this new lecture also. So till now we have discussed the preparation strategy for GATE architecture and planning. We have discussed in detail GATE 2021 question paper in architecture and planning. We have also discussed about which are the recruitment exams where you can appear, and these exams are similar to GATE exam. The syllabus is more or less same. And in that lecture, we have discussed that in the next lecture, that means in today's lecture, we are going to discuss about the frequently asked numerical questions in the building acoustics section. So one by one, we will do the analysis of the earlier year questions. First, we will understand what is the basic data related to those numerical questions, more or less the theory. And then one by one, we will solve the questions. First, we will solve the easy problems, and one by one, we will reach the difficult one. So let's start the today's lecture with the basic data. So the first definition is sound pressure level. Generally, we used to drop this word pressure and we used to call it as a sound level. So sound pressure level, it is described in terms of decibels. In short, we used to write dB. But more or often, sound intensity is described in decibels, but it is wrong. Sound intensity is measured in watt per meter square, whereas sound pressure level is measured in terms of decibel. So please note down this in your notes. Then the next one is ideal sound pressure for normal human being is 40 to 55 dB. Please note down this also. Ideal sound pressure level for hearing condition is 40 to 55 dB. So beyond that will be the noisy one. So sound level of 75 to 95 dB is considered as a noisy. So, based on this particular note, the question has been asked earlier related to the what is the acceptable noise level in various spaces. For example, in theater, the acceptable noise level will be different. In classroom, it will be different. So, based on that, the question was asked earlier in GATE 2005, 2001, 97 and ISRO 2015. The next definition is sound intensity level. As we already discussed in previous note, that sound intensity, it describes the loudness of sound, whereas sound pressure whereas decibels describe the sound pressure level. So sound intensity describes the loudness of sound, and it is calculated in terms of SI unit, that is watts per meter square. Then the next definition is frequency of sound. What is mean by frequency of sound? We have studied this in our school life, that the frequency of sound waves refers to how often the particles of the medium vibrate when a wave passes through the medium. So it is measured in terms of hertz. 1 hertz is equal to 1 vibration per second. This is also an important definition. So based on that, 125 hertz to 250 hertz, this frequency of sound, they are called as a low frequency sound, like a bass. 500 hertz is the speech, what you are here right now. When I'm talking, the frequency of sound is 500 hertz. Above 2000 hertz to 8000 hertz, this sound is generally termed as a high frequency sound. For example, musical instruments like violin, guitar, these sounds are high frequency sound. Okay, next. The next definition, very important related to our numerical problems, is reverberation time. In short, we used to call it as a RT. So what is the definition? It is the time required for the sound to fade away or decay in a closed space. For example, if I am talking a word, say word, so it will fade away in some kind, in some time. So what is the time required to fade away after the sound is propagated? So it is called as a reverberation time. So it is defined as the time taken by the sound to decay by 60 decibels, which is denoted as RT60 or T60. So as per NBC, the maximum reverberation time should be in the range of 1 to 1.25 second. For assembly halls, in full condition, if it is all the people have occupied their seats and the hall is fully occupied, then the reverberation time should be in the range of 1 to 1.25 seconds. While for noise controlling in empty condition, it should be within the range of 1.5 to 2 seconds. So generally, the shorter reverberation time are desirable for noise control or wherever possible, so that you won't hear the echo in the closed condition. So based on these basic data, we are going to solve the numerical problems question from the earlier year GATE papers. So first we will solve the easy problems and then afterwards we will solve the difficult one. So the first problem is related to the definition what we saw in the earlier slide. The time required for sound to decay to 60 dB is called as. This question was asked in ISRO 2015. So the correct option is option C, reverberation time. In UPSC MES 2019, the same question was repeated. The time in seconds required for a sound made in an enclosed space to diminish by 60 dB is called as. Again here, the correct option is option C. Then in GATE 1995, they have asked the optimum reverberation time for public lecture hall should not exceed. Now, this particular range we have discussed while defining the definition of reverberation time. So what is the explanation here? As per NBC, the maximum reverberation time should be in the range of 1 to 1.25, usually for the assembly halls for acoustic reason, like we discussed in the previous slide, when it is fully occupied. While to avoid the echo in empty condition, it should be in the range of 1.5 to 2.0. But in general, the shorter reverberation time is desirable to avoid the echo and for the noise control. So here, the correct option among the four given option will be option B, 1.5 seconds. Because here, the given option are 1 second, 2 second and 2.5 second. So 2 second and 2.5 second are definitely not the correct option. 1.5 second, that the optimum reverberation time for public should not exceed. So beyond 1.5 second is not the desirable one. So here the correct option is option B. Okay, so before solving the next problems, we are again going to discuss some basic data related to those problems. The first one is reverberation time was first established by Sabine. The name of the person was Sabine, and by this name, the unit has been assigned to this total absorption area. So, which was calculated based on the volume of the room and the total absorption or reflection surface on the wall, ceiling, floor, etc. So, this Sabine formula is used for the simple calculation of reverberation time. So, what is the formula? Reverberation time is equal to 0.049 into V upon A. What is V? V is the volume expressed in cubic feet and A is the area expressed in square feet. So based on that, the question was asked earlier in ISRO 2020. This equation was given and it was asked what is the RT, reverberation time. But we are using the metric scale right now. So reverberation time in the metric scale, the equation will be reverberation time is equal to 0.16 into V upon A. These two are the constant, 0.049 and 0.16, these are constant. In metric scale, volume will be expressed in terms of cubic meter and area will be expressed in terms of square meter, Sabine square meter. Okay, so based on that, the next question we are going to discuss is from GATE 1992. Reverberation time inside a theater depends upon, just we have discussed that two quantities will be define what will be the reverberation time. So which are these quantities? One is the volume and second is the absorption area. So among these option, among the four option, what is the A? Structural strength of the room, definitely not the correct one. Shape of the room, roof, no. Heat generated in the hall, no, this is also the wrong answer. Then the correct answer is volume of the hall. So here the correct, as our equation says, reverberation time is equal to 0.16 into volume upon area. So basically what we can say, reverberation time, it is inversely proportional to the absorption area and it is directly proportional to the volume. So here correct answer is answer C, option C. The next question, it is a numerical type. From GATE 2018, a room of 3 meter by 3 meter by 3 meter has a reverberation time of 0.8 second. Using Sabine's method, the total absorption in the room is dash Sabine's. We have to calculate the what is the total absorption area. Right now, reverberation time, that is RT, has been provided. The dimension of the room has been provided. We have to just calculate what is the volume and we have to find out the answer. So here volume will be 3 into 3 into 3, that is 27 meter cube. Reverberation time, it is already given 0.8 second. Absorption area, we have to find in meter square sabine. So just put the values in this equation. RT equal to 0.16 into V upon A. So A will be 0.16 V divided by RT. So the answer will be 5.4 sabine. So this is one mark question. The answer is easy. The answer, the range of the answer given in the as per final key was 5.3 to 5.7. So our answer is correct one. The next question, again the simpler one from GATE 2014. The capacity of hall is 600 persons and its volume is 300 cubic meter. Volume is 3000 cubic meter. If an optimum reverberation time of 1 second is to be achieved, that means we have to achieve RT is equal to 1 second, then the required total absorption meter square sabine is. It is just similar to the earlier problem. So we have noted down volume is equal to 3000 meter cube, RT is 1 second. We have to just find out the A, that is area. So RT is equal to 0.16 V upon A. Just do the cross multiplication, area will be 480 meter square sabine. So here the answer will be 480. Okay, now let's go to the next question. It is from GATE 2011 and there are two questions based on the information provided which are called as linked answer questions. So the statement for linked answer question 52 and 53 is as follows. An auditorium having volume of 4500 cubic meter and total absorption of all acoustic material is 480 meter square sabine. The reverberation time of the auditorium is, simple one, just we have to find RT by putting the values in the equation. RT equal to 0.161 into V upon A. Sometime we use just 0.16. You can use the further values 0.161 also. So here V is the 4500 meter cube, A is 480 meter square. So reverberation time by putting the values in the equation will be 1.5 seconds. So here the correct option will be option B. The simple one marks question you can easily solve. So just don't lose marks in this kind of question. So here the correct option is answer B, 1.5 seconds. What is the next question related to this information? To reduce reverberation time by 0.5 second, additional absorption required would be. Now, what is the reverberation time we have find out right now? It is 1.5 second. We have to reduce it by 0.5 second. We don't require reverberation time as 0.5 second. We have to reduce by 0.5 second. So here, the required reverberation time will be 1 second. Please read the question carefully. And they are asking additional absorption required would be. What was given in the earlier given information. So here, as I said, reverberation time will be 1 second. Volume is as it is. There is no change. It is 4500 meter cube, and area we have to find out. So just putting this value in the equation, we will get by doing the cross multiplication area equal to 724.5 meter square. Now please just as I said read the question carefully. The answer which is very close to this answer is already given, that is 720, but 720 is not the answer, or 724.5 meter square is not answer. We have to find out what is the additional absorption required from what was the value given in the given information. So the additional absorption required will be 724.5 minus what was the already available, so which was 480 meter square. So the additional absorption required will be 244.5 meter square. So here the nearest answer to the final answer is 240. So we can select this answer as a option C, 240. So here the correct answer is option C, 240 meters. Sometimes it happens that generally they don't provide this kind of a correct answer, so we can select the answer nearby to that range. Okay, the next question is from GATE 2009. It is again similar like the earlier one. They have given some kind of a common information for related to two problems. The seminar hall has a volume of 2000 cubic meter and total absorption of all acoustic materials without any audience is 80 meter square sabines. The reverberation time of the empty hall in seconds. Just put the values in the equation RT equal to 0.16 V upon A as given. So here reverberation time will be 4.025 second. It is much more than what is the desirable, but they are saying it is in the empty hall. So the reverberation time of the empty hall, if we compare with the nearest answer to this answer will be option B, 4 second. So here the correct answer will be option B. What is the 54th question related to this information? When the seminar hall is filled with the audience, the reverberation time is recorded as 2 seconds. Now RT, the value of RT changed, it is now 2 seconds. Then total absorption of all acoustic material will be, volume is given in the earlier information. Right now we have to find out what is the value of A. So here V equal to as given in the given information, it is 2000 meter cube, reverberation time is 2 second, area we have to find out. So just put the values, again it is a simpler one, A equal to 161 meter square. So what is the nearest answer here? It will be option C, 160, the nearest one. Okay, so let's go to the next question. The next question is from GATE 2008. A school auditorium has a capacity of 800 persons, considering 3.5 cubic meter of volume per person. Now see, they have not mentioned directly the volume of the hall. They have mentioned what is the total capacity, that is 800%, and what is the requirement per person, which is 3.5 cubic meter. So the total volume of that auditorium will be just 800 by 3.5 will be the total volume. What they have mentioned further, they have mentioned reverberation time is 1.25 second. The total sound absorption area required would be, so just we'll write down what is the value given. As I said, volume is equal to 800 into 3.5, that will be 2800 meter cube. Reverberation time they have mentioned at 1.25 second, we have to just identify what is the A. So just put the values in the equation. A will be 358.4 meter square. So what is the nearest answer here is option B. Yes, okay. The next question is from GATE 2007. An auditorium has a volume of 3000 meter cube with optimum reverberation time of 0.8 seconds. Sound absorption power required in the auditorium in meter square sabines is approximately. Again, the simple one, just put the values in the equation and find out the answer. These are all one mark question, one can easily solve and one should not lose marks in such kind of a simple questions. So here volume will be 3000 meter cube, reverberation time they have mentioned 0.8 second. Just put the values, answer will be 600 meter square sabine. So here the correct answer will be option C. The next question, again it is from GATE 2007. During a convocation program in the same auditorium, the absorption power increases by 200 meter square sabines. Now this is a problem related to the given data. The absorption power increases by 200 meter square. So what was the power in the earlier one, absorption power? We have find out it is 600. Now it is increased to the, that means total absorption has been increased by 200 meter square. So what will be the right now A, the volume, the value of A will be 600 plus 200, that will be 800 meter square. So they are asking the reverberation time in seconds will be now. What will be the change? What will be the new reverberation time? So as I said, V, volume is same, reverberation time we have to find out. A value, that means earlier, what was the total absorption earlier? It was 600 meter square sabine. Right now, it has been increased by 200 meter square. So the new value of A will be 800 meter square sabine. So we have to find out what is the value of RT. So just put the values in the equation. The final answer will be 0.6 seconds. So just read the question carefully and then try to solve the problem. So here the correct option will be option B. Very easy problems till now we have solved, and after solving these easy problems we will further discuss the difficult one. So what is the next question? It is from GATE 2006. An auditorium of size 30 meter by 20 meter is 8 meter high. So right now they have again mentioned the dimension. Assuming optimum reverberation time of 1.2 seconds and existing absorption power of the hall as 300 meter square. So means calculate the extra absorption required, absorption units required. Right now they have not directly asked to calculate what is the absorption, total absorption required. They have just mentioned right now existing capacity is 300 meter square sabine, how much more will be required. So just put the values of V, A and RT here. We have to find out the value of A. So just put the values of V and RT in the equation and find out what is the value of A. So as per the equation, the value will be 640 meter square. Okay. So the extra absorption required beyond 300 meter square will be 640 minus 300. So the required more absorption will be 340 meter square. So correct option will be option B, 340 meter square sub-ions. Okay, let's go to the next question. It is again related to the earlier problems, the earlier one. So what they are asking in this particular problem, extra absorption units in the above auditorium can be achieved by using indigenous acoustic materials. Okay, if the area available for fixing acoustical materials is 580 meter square, okay, of which 40 square meter are openings covered with heavy curtains. So 580, just 40 has been, you know, subtracted from the total area. So net area right now is 540 square meter, because 40 square meter has been used to this area is includes the openings which has been covered with the heavy curtains. So what they are asking, the absorption coefficient of curtains is 0.5. okay, identify a single acoustical material for the remaining area. We have to find out which material we can use for the remaining area. So what is the remaining area? It is 540 square meter. So that 540 square meter area should be covered with such a material that we have to achieve the reverberation time what was given in the earlier one. So let's solve this question step by step. So total absorption will be area of material into absorption coefficient. The value of A, it is calculated by area of material into its absorption coefficient. That is mean by total absorption. So 340 equal to area of wall with the material of absorption coefficient into x into absorption coefficient of wall minus area covered by curtains into absorption coefficient. Now see, from where these values have been taken, it has been taken from the earlier problems. See, 340 square meter is the extra absorption requirement of 340 meter square. So extra, in the given problem they have mentioned, extra absorption units in the above auditorium can be achieved by using indigenous acoustic material. We have to find from the given four options, we have to find out which is the suitable acoustic material and wherein they have mentioned the coefficient of absorption. We have to find the coefficient of absorption. And by that value, we will decide whether this material will be suitable or not. So this total absorption will be area of material into its absorption coefficient. That means capital A equal to what is the total area occupied by that material into what is the specific absorption coefficient. Each material will have different absorption coefficient depending upon its properties. So here 340 will be area of wall with a material of absorption coefficient, which we have to find out, into absorption coefficient of that wall minus area covered by curtains into absorption coefficient of curtains. So in that we have to 340 meter square, this is the extra absorption units we have to we have already calculated. 540 is the area of the wall, 580 meter square minus 40, this is the opening. So the net area of the wall will be 540 meter square into x. We have to find it out. We don't know what is the absorption coefficient of this wall. We don't know what is the material that we have to find out. Minus 40. This is the area of opening into what is the coefficient of this curtain is given. Coefficient of that material is 0.50. So just do the calculation here. 340 equal to 540 into x minus 40 into 0.5. So the value of x will be 0.60. So what is x? It is the absorption coefficient of wall. So that means whatever material we will select, the absorption coefficient of that material should be 0.60. So let's see from the given four option, what is the absorption coefficient they have mentioned. For the option A, they have mentioned 0.36. For the B, they have mentioned 0.60. In the C option, they have mentioned 0.20. And in the D option, they have mentioned 0.30. So here, this B option, that means 18 mm thick compounded wood particle board having a coefficient of absorption 0.60. See, just don't get confused by this material specification. What is important is coefficient of absorption, so which is 0.60. So here the correct answer will be this option B. So again, we are going to discuss some basic data again for the related to the further problems. We are going deeper into deeper. So the basic data related for the further related problem is Sabine formula. As we have discussed, reverberation time is equal to 0.16 into V upon A. Sorry, I missed reverberation time here. Reverberation time is equal to 0.16 into V upon A in the metric scale, where volume is expressed in cubic meter and absorption area is expressed in square meter. So sometimes this area of absorption is calculated by taking area of each product added separately. Like we discussed in the earlier problem, this area of absorption depends upon the total area covered by that material into its absorption coefficient. So this value, generally it is called as noise reduction criteria value. Each product will have different NRC value. So this A, the capital A, we can further subdivide into A1 into A1 plus A2 into A2 plus A3 into A3. So what is A1 and what is the small A1 and what is the capital A1? See, An in this equation, An, that is capital N, is one section of absorptant area. That means area of that particular material. Suppose there is a wall of 4 meter by 3 meter. So 12 square meter will be the capital A, that means the actual area available for covering the surface, whereas small an is the absorption coefficient of that particular material. Like in the earlier problem, they have mentioned the absorption coefficient of that particular material will be 0.60. So here an is the absorption coefficient of that particular material. So based on that, again, the further problems are based on this further subdivision or further deeper information related to the Sabine formula. So you will understand when we will solve this problem, how these values we can, you know, subdivide further. So GATE 2016, the question was, question 44. For a room with a dimension 4 meter by 3 meter by 3 meter, that is length into breadth into height, the details of indoor acoustic material treatment are as follows. So what they have mentioned, the components they have subdivided, that means they have subdivided into wall, ceiling and floor. So if there is a room, they have treated the wall with a different material, ceiling with a different material and floor with a different material. Again, for 30 square meter area, they have treated the 30 square meter area of wall with a material having absorption coefficient of 0.4, whereas 70% of the wall has been treated with the with the material having absorption coefficient of 0.1. So the value of small a in this case is 0.4, and for the 70 square meter area, the value of small a is 0.1. Similarly for the ceiling and similarly for the floor. So what they are asking, the reverberation time in seconds at 1000 Hertz is. So this is a 2 marks question, require a little bit more time than the earlier problem. So here we will tabulate the information वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग डू रिमेंबर फॉर द एट द एक्चुअल टाइम ऑफ गेट क्वेश्चन पेपर मोस्ट ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम्स यू हैव टू सॉल्व बाई टैबुलेटिंग द इंफॉर्मेशन सो वेन एवर यू विल स्टार्ट सॉल्विंग द प्रॉब्लम जस्ट मेक द टेबल्स क्लियरली डोंट राइट इन द रनिंग लैंग्वेज सो दैट यू विल यू वोंट यू विल फाइंड डिफिकल्ट टू रीड योर ओन वैल्यूज Just tabulate the information very neatly and step by step calculate the answer. So here we can draw simply one figure from the given information that 4 meter is the length, breadth is 3 meter and height is the 3 meter. So based on that we can tabulate the information from the given information that the component, the total area of the wall will be 4 meter by 3 meter into 4 meter by 3 meter into 2. Sorry, 4 meter by 3 meter, 4 meter by 3 meter plus 3 meter by 3 meter. So total area of wall will be 42 square meter. The ceiling will be again 4 into 3, 12 square meter and floor will be 4 into 3, 12 square meter. Here we have calculated the total area of all four walls. So they have mentioned the particular percentage area for the treatment of those surfaces. So we will find out what is the value of 30% of 42 square meter, what is the value of 70% of 42 and similar like this. So the actual area of this for this acoustical treatment, like I said, 30% of 40 square meter will be 0.3 into 42, which will be 12.6. So similarly, we will calculate 70% of 42 will be 29.4, 40% of 12 will be 4.8, 60% of 12 will be 7.2, and here floor they have mentioned as 100% they have treated with the one single material which is having absorption coefficient of 0.1. So here 100% that means we will take the value of 12 square meter as it is. Now they have mentioned in the given information that the absorption coefficient for this particular material is 0.4. Here it is 0.1, it is 0.6, 0.1 and 0.1. Just as it is, we have again copied the values from the given table. So here what we have to do, as I said in the earlier slide, this is the value of capital A and this is the value of small a. So An into An will be the capital A. So An into An, which will be 12.6 into 0.4 will be 5.04. Similarly, 29.4 into 0.1 will be 2.94. And similarly, 4.8 into 0.6, 2.88, 7.2 into 0.1, 0.72. 12 into 0.1 will be 1.2. So An into An we have find out here. So what is the total of what is the value of capital A? That means total absorption will be the addition of all these values. So just add these values in the equation. So reverberation time is equal to 0.161 into V upon A, whereas A, this absorption, is the addition of all these figures. So here A will be total room absorption in subions. So which is, just add this 5.04 plus 2.94 plus 2.88 plus 0.72 plus 1.2. So what is the total? It is 12.78. So just put the values in the equation, 0.161 into V upon RT is equal to 0.161 V upon A. That means we will put the values of volume is 36. And what is the value we have found out here? It is what is the value of A? It is 12.78. So the final answer will be 0.45 second just by doing the cross multiplication. So what is the final answer as per the answer key? It was in the range of 0.44 to 0.46. And what is the value we have found out right now? It is 0.45. So our answer is correct. It is in the range. We will get the full marks. So this is a 2 marks question. We have just calculated by tabulating the information and we have find out what is the total absorption by calculating different values for that different particular material. Let's go to the next question. Okay, the next question is from GATE 2021, the latest one. We have also discussed this while solving the GATE 2020 on paper. So again, we will solve this related to the basic data we have discussed right now in previous slide. So it is a 2-mark question. A rectangular hall having dimension of 8 meter by 14 meter by 14 by 4 meter has total 4 windows. What is the window size? It is 1.5 meter by 1.0 meter. Just draw a rectangle. And what is the length and breadth? It is 14 meter by 8 meter. And this is the height. We will assume this, though they have not clearly mentioned. The window size is provided. There are such 4 windows having a size of 1.5 by 1 meter and 2 doors having a size of 1 meter by 2 meter each. The coefficient of absorption are given below. Considering all windows open and doors closed, the reverberation time in second is how much? Now the new condition has been added. What is different from the earlier solved problems? That right now they have mentioned all windows are open and doors are closed. Now we have to find out the reverberation time in second. So this is little bit further difficult to the whatever problems we have solved earlier. So here they have mentioned what is the absorption coefficient for the typical material, like for the wall, floor and ceiling. They have used the material having an absorption coefficient of 0.2, whereas the absorption coefficient for door and window, it is 0.4. So again, here we have to tabulate the information. We have to calculate the values by putting these values in a very sophisticated and in the tabular form. Just write the values in clearly so that you will understand what you are solving right now. So similar question was also asked in GATE 2019. Very similar question if one has solved this question early in the previous paper. Solving GATE 2021 question 44 was the easy one. So I will just read the question of 40 question 46 of GATE 2019. It is the internal dimension of a room is 10 by 10 by 4. The total area of the door and windows are 16 meter square. Keeping the doors and windows closed, the reverberation time of the room becomes 1.2 second. Here they have mentioned the first condition as the doors and windows are closed. The reverberation time was calculated, which was 1.2 seconds. Assume all the interior surface, including doors and windows, have same sound absorption coefficient. See, in 2021, they have bifurcated it. They have used the different material for the wall, floor and ceiling and different material for door and window. Here, they have used the same material for doors, windows, as well as for the walls. If all doors and windows of the room are kept fully open, the reverberation time will be. We will solve this problem in the further slide. But first, we will concentrate on the GATE 2021 question 44. So from the given information, the total volume of wall will be 8 meter by 14 meter into 4 meter. So which will be 448 meter cube. Now we have to find out what is the value of A. So here, total area of 4 walls plus ceiling plus 4. So 2 into, there will be these 2 walls will be of dimension 14 by 4 plus these 2 walls will be of dimension 8 by 4. So 2 into 14 by 4 plus 2 into 8 by 4 plus 2 into the total area of floor plus ceiling will be 14 into 8. So that means plus 2 into 14 by 8. So the addition will be 400 square meters. So we have find out right now what is the value of A, so which is 400 square meter. So total area of 4 windows, they have mentioned dimension of each window, which is 1.5 by 1 meter. So multiply by 4, total area of 4 windows will be 6 square meter. Similarly, total area of 2 doors, the dimension of area, the dimension of door is 1 by 2. So just multiply by 2, the total area of 2 doors will be 4 square meter. Now, the net area of 4 walls plus ceiling plus 4 floor, excluding the 4 windows and doors. Why we are excluding? Because these windows and doors, they have been treated with the different material having a different coefficient, absorption coefficient. So, the net area of 4 walls plus ceiling plus floor will be, excluding these 4 windows and doors, will be 400 minus. What is the area for windows and doors will be 10, this total will be 10. So the net area of walls, ceiling and floor will be 390 square meter. Okay, so again we will tabulate this, the components wall, floor and ceiling, and doors and windows. These two components have been treated with the different material. So here, what is the net area we have find out just right now? It is 390 square meter. The absorption coefficient given for the treatment for the wall, floor and ceiling as per the given information, that is small an, is 0.2. Whereas for doors and windows, we have calculated the total area, which is 6 plus 4, which is 10. The absorption coefficient given for this treatment is 0.4. So an into an, the multiplication of 390 into 0.2 will be 78, 10 into 0.4 will be 4. So right now we have to identify what is the value of capital A by just adding these two values. So 78 plus 4 will be 82 meter square. So for all doors and windows closed, this is the condition when we have all doors and windows closed. So 82 meter square will be the total area of absorption. So reabrasion time RT is equal to 0.6 into V upon A as per our standard equation. So we will just put the values of V, volume, V equal to 448 meter cube. A value we have just identified as 82. So the reabrasion time will be 0.87 second when all the doors and windows are closed, so that each material it is now active and each material is absorbing the sound as per their own property. So 0.87 second is the reabrasion time at that condition when all doors and windows are closed. But they have mentioned some different condition. So what is the condition? They have mentioned when all windows are open and doors are closed, we have to find the reverberation time. See, 0.87 second is not the final answer. We have to calculate the answer for the specific condition that all windows are open and doors are closed. So as per condition, if windows are open, then the coefficient of absorption will be 1, because there will be when at this condition, when windows are open, there will be total absorption of sound. So the coefficient of absorption will be 1, an equal to 1. Whenever this condition is given that some doors are open or windows is open, we have to just take the value of coefficient of absorption is equal to 1. So we will just, you know, bifurcate this the above table into again two different columns. Now this wall, floor and ceiling will be same as it is. The area is not changed, 390.2. The total value of A will be 78 by just doing them. Now we have to bifurcate because right now doors are closed and windows are open. So we will again divide this column into two different columns. For the door, we will calculate the different one, and for the window, we will calculate the values as separate one. So here, the total area of door is, we have identified here, the total area of two doors is 4 square meter. We will write down the value of an as 4. The coefficient of absorption they have mentioned for doors and windows, 0.4, because right now doors is closed, so the material is as it is here, which is 0.4, having the coefficient of absorption is as 0.4. So just do the multiplication, we will get the value of an. This the multiplication an into an will be 1.6. Now here for windows, as I said earlier, the coefficient of absorption in the condition when the windows are open will be 1. So 6 into 1 will be 6. So just do the addition of this value, we will get the new A. That means the total absorption in meter square turbines. So which will be 78 plus 1.6 plus 6. So the total will be 85.6. Now we have to just put this value in the reverberation time equation and we will get the new reverberation time. So here, RT is equal to 0.16 into V upon A. So V, volume, is as it is 448. Now instead of the earlier value of 82, we will just put the new value of total absorption as 85.6. Just do the cross multiplication. The answer will be 0.837 second. So this is the final answer at that condition when all windows are open and doors are closed. So this is the final answer. So as per final answer key, the range of correct answer was in the range of 0.82 to 0.86, whereas we have find out the answer is 0.837. So our answer is in this range, we'll get the full marks. So this was the 2 marks question, easy to solve, but just carefully put the values in the table format so that you won't get confused while solving the problem. So let's just discuss the next problem. The next problem, as we discussed in the earlier slide that is question 46, which was very similar to GATE 2021. The internal dimension of a room is 10 meter by 10 meter by 4 meter. Here they have particularly mentioned 4 meter is the height. The total area of the doors and windows are 16 meter square. They have not specifically mentioned what is the area of doors and what is the area of window. Together they have mentioned total area is 16 meter square. Keeping the doors and windows closed, the reverberation time of the room was calculated and it was found out that it was 1.2 second. Assume all the interior surfaces including doors and windows have same sound absorption coefficient. If all the doors and windows of the room are kept fully open, the reverberation time will be how much? So here, like in earlier problem, they have mentioned the coefficient of absorption different for the wall, floor and ceiling and different for doors and windows. So here they have mentioned that all the interior surface, wall, floor, ceiling, including doors and windows have same sound absorption coefficient. So this question is little bit easy than the earlier one. So we'll tabulate the information given. So here the total volume of room will be 10 by 10 by 4, so which will be 400 meter cube. Total area absorption, which will be total wall area plus total floor area plus total ceiling area. So 4 into 10 by 4 plus 10 into 10 plus 10 into 10. So what is the total area of absorption? We just add this figure, which will be 360 meter square. Total area of doors and windows, they have mentioned as 16 meter square here. Thus net area, because here they have mentioned including this dimension of wall is including the doors and windows. So we have to identify what is the net area of wall, floor and ceiling. That means only the area of doors and windows will be subtracted from the area of wall. There will be no change in floor and ceiling. So 360 minus 16 will be 344 meter square. See, this is the net area of wall, floor plus ceiling. So formula to calculate the reverberation time, as we know, it is reverberation time is equal to 0.16 into V upon A, where V is equal to volume, A is total room absorption in sabines. So by this condition, as we discuss how to, further subdivide this capital A, that is total room absorption in the room depends upon the coefficient of absorption into the area covered by that particular material. So here in this problem, all the interior surfaces, as they have clearly mentioned here, that all the interior surface including doors and windows have same sound absorption coefficient. So reverberation time they have mentioned as 1.2 second. The absorption coefficient is unknown. We don't know what is the absorption coefficient here. So we'll just assume the total area of absorption including doors and windows as A1, which is 360 meter square, because here we have calculated what is the total area of absorption. That means what is the net area of what is the total area including wall, floor and ceiling, so which is 360 meter square. So assume the net area excluding doors and windows is A2. This is the A2 we have calculated. We have just assumed that this is the A2. We have just assumed that this area 360 meter is the A1 and 344 square meter, which is the net area excluding the doors and windows as A2. So here, for calculating the value of absorption coefficient, the formula is standard 0.16 V upon A. But here again A, we will further subdivide into A1 into A1. So this 1.2 second, this reverberation time was achieved when doors and windows were closed. When doors and windows were closed, so the entire area we can take while calculating the reverberation time. So that means we can take the value of A as 360. Here, the value of the entire, the total area, including doors, windows, and as well as floor and ceiling, we can take as a 360. When all the doors and windows were closed, they have achieved the reverberation time of 1.2 seconds. So here, we will take the value of capital A1 as 360. We don't know what is the absorption coefficient. So by doing the cross multiplication, we will get the value of absorption coefficient, which will be A1 equal to 0.148. So let's just, which is more or less equal to 0.15, which will be absorption coefficient for the different material. So in the second condition, they have mentioned that right now we have identified the absorption coefficient of the material, which is required while calculating the reverberation time when windows and rooms are kept fully open, because in that case, the absorption coefficient will be 1 because they are open. So we have to just put the value as per the what is the value we have find out here of A1. We have to put this value in the further calculation. So here in the problem, like I said, all the interior surfaces including doors and windows have same sound absorption coefficient. It is given that reverberation time of the room is 1.2 second in the given problem only. So assume the total area of absorption including doors and windows, like we have assumed, it is 360 meter square. So for calculating the reverberation time RT when doors and windows are open, like we discussed in the earlier problem, when they are open, their absorption coefficient will be 1. So right now we have to find out what is the reverberation time when both windows and doors are kept fully open. So RT will be unknown, 0.16 into V upon A. So here A2, when windows and doors are open, we will not take the value of the area of doors and windows. So we will take the value of the net area excluding doors and windows. So which will be A2 into A1, because they have the remaining material, the wall, floor and ceiling will have the same absorption coefficient. So here the value of A1 will be 0.15. So just put this value 0.16 into volume is same as it is. A2 value we will put the net area excluding doors and windows, so which will be 344 into 0.15, right? 0.15 plus, now we have to here again identify A2 into A1 plus, what is the, why we have taken this one value, because 16 is the area of doors and windows into the their absorption coefficient as they are kept fully open, it will be 1. So here by doing the cross multiplication, we will get the value of reverberation time is equal to 0.946. So we more or less equal to 0.95 second, approximately 0.95 second by doing the cross multiplication. So here we have taken similar like the earlier one, we have taken the net area of wall, floor and ceiling excluding doors and windows into absorption coefficient for that particular material plus the value of area of doors and windows into, as they are kept fully open, the value of absorption coefficient will be 1. So by doing the cross multiplication, we have find out the value of reverberation time, which is approximately equal to 0.95 seconds. So what was the answer for this? As per the correct final answer key was in the range of 0.93 to 0.97. So our answer is in the range, we'll get full 2 marks. So this is the last problem related to the reverberation time and which was asked in earlier year gate question papers. So before ending, let's summarize what we have learned so far in today's lecture. We have studied few terms and their respective units or in which these units are measured. The quantities are measured. The first term is sound pressure level, which is expressed in terms of decibels. The important note related to this term is 40 to 55 dB is the ideal hearing condition Beyond that, 75 to 95 dB is considered as a noisy. Then the next term we studied is sound intensity level, which is expressed in watts per meter square. So generally it is the energy, sound intensity level is, it is the energy. It is power in terms of power per meter square, power per unit area. The third definition or the third term we have studied is the frequency of sound, which is expressed in terms of hertz. Hertz, that means one vibration per second, and 500 hertz is the frequency of speech which you hear. Then the next important term related to the numerical problems is the reverberation time. In short, we used to write as a RT. So the time taken by sound to decay by 60 dB is known as the reverberation time. So the maximum reverberation time in enclosed space for the assembly halls, it should be in the range of 1 second to 1.25 second as per the National Building Code. This is also an important point to be noted down. Who derived the formula reverberation time was first established by Sabine. By this name, the unit has been considered as reverberation time is equal to 0.16 into V upon A, whereas A is absorption area in meter square Sabine, if it is expressed in metric scale. So here in this formula, 0.16 is the constant, V is the volume of that enclosed space, which is expressed in terms of cubic meter, A is the total absorption area, which is expressed in square meter Sabine or Sabine square meter. So sometimes it happens that more than one material is used for the surface treatment. So for example, if there are more than one material is used for surface treatment, this absorption area is calculated by taking area of each product added separately. That means this A can be further, it can be described as small A1 into capital A1, whereas small A1, this A1 is the absorption coefficient for material 1, whereas A1 is the surface area covered by that specific material. Similarly, we can take the multiplication of the absorption coefficient into that respective surface area of the material 2. So in this way, if we add this multiplication, we will get the total area of absorption. So based on that, we have solved these numerical problems, and these numerical problems are very easy to solve. Just remember this formula, and sometimes it may happen that the problems may be lengthy, but just formulate, just tabulate the information, just try to solve the problems in the tabulate form at the exam so that it will be easy for you to solve the problems. So at the end, I would like to just inform that in the next lecture, we are going to study frequently asked numerical questions in housing and building bylaws. These problems are also easy to solve. Right now, just to inform that we have started from the easy questions where one should not lose the marks. So these reverberation time for questions or the building acoustic section numericals, as well as housing and building bylaws section numericals, they are very easy to solve. One can easily solve it and one should not lose marks in these questions. So we are going to discuss about the frequently asked numerical questions in the next lecture. So till that time, I hope you have liked this video and liked the lecture. So I would request that do like, comment and share this video with your friends. And one more thing, if you want to understand how it is solved in the book, one can open that particular question in the guidebook and again see the lecture one by one, understand how the explanation has been given step by step by alternatively seeing in the video lecture. So thank you so much for watching this lecture, and we will meet in the next lecture, which is on the frequently asked numerical question in housing and building bylaws. So till that time, all the best, and do prepare hard, and wish you all the best. Thank you.